Yo, old Snapchat, so at least in the developed world, our basic human needs, things like food, water, clothing, electricity, and communication, they're basically inexpensive, abundant commodities. But somehow we've ended up in a reality where that final human need, shelter, has actually been exploited as an investment vehicle by rent collectors and rent seekers who add little value back to society. I mean, in 2016, like, owning property has kind of become a bit of a running joke for my generation. I just saw a status update from a friend saying that a one-bedroom apartment near his area was selling for $730,000. And when you're talking about absolutely fucking ridiculous prices like that is not being driven by housing demand. That is being driven by investors who are speculating, who are hoping to buy that property, hope the market goes up so they can flip the property for a profit. And this is basically a perfect example of, like, government intervention fucking with the free market system. I mean, the reason why those things are going up so much is because so many people are buying property because of rules like negative gearing. Like, when the government actually enables the middle-income families and low-income families to actually start buying these investment properties because of the rules they put in place, that's when it messes everything up. And because of these government interventions, tax rules, and incentives, it means that one-bedroom $730,000 apartment will definitely sell within weeks, because there's basically, like, very little risk to the investor. Because with negative gearing, I think the way it basically works is that you can get a massive loan to buy the whole property, and then your interest payments are huge, but basically the income you get from rental covers most of that. But the rental income doesn't actually cover the entire interest costs. But what you can then do is the tax office actually allows you to make a deduction on that loss. The fuck is this system? And then so basically you're making a loss the entire time. You only make a gain when you sell the property. So you're hoping the property prices will go up. And they are going up because it's a fucking Ponzi scheme that everyone's investing into. So now we got this, like, runaway snowball effect where property prices are massively inflated to the point where, you know, the average person's never going to be able to own a property in their lifetime. But obviously, as more people invest in this Ponzi scheme, the prices will continue to go higher, which means the loan repayments will continue to rise, which means tenants and people renting will get fucked over. And if you can't afford to own your own property or your own home, then basically you have to rent. And when you're renting, you're basically paying back your landlord's interest costs on the loan they took out to get that property. And as a result, rent prices go up. And this is why I think already now, like, probably half of people's income is going towards rent and shelter. So this is all fucked. How do we fix this? Well, the government started this problem so they could fix it, but they're not going to do that. There's no incentive for them to do that, and I have zero belief in governments fixing problems like this because they started in the first place. I did post one future video, I think many, many months back, talking about maybe, like, some type of blockchain-based system that tries to basically, over time, buy back all the properties and give them to the social commons. A perhaps more realistic and pragmatic approach might be to basically leverage the whole self-driving car thing. I mean, that's happening faster than anyone expects. We're basically going to have self-driving cars well within 3 to 5 years. The beauty about self-driving cars is, like, they're not going to be like traditional cars. Like, we're going to end up having self-driving cars that have a gym in them, have a cafe in them, have, like, you know, couches, have beds, have everything. And because these self-driving cars will be all on demand, you basically pick the type of car you want to drive in that morning. If you live 2 or 3 hours out of a city, it's not really commute time anymore. It's more like leisure time or do whatever you want time. I even like the idea of, like, self-driving homes. Like, why can't you just, like, live completely in, like, almost like a truck that's just, like, self-driving? Pure electric, it's, like, got everything you need in there. Then you compare that technology with rising technologies like VR and AR, and 5G speeds and fiber speeds, as pretty much this idea that you can work and live anywhere you want. And then 3D printing homes. This is something that's still in its infancy, and no one's really seems to be pursuing it in a very aggressive way yet. So they did just 3D print an office building in Dubai. So they printed a 250 square meter office building over 17 days via prefabricated methods on a 37 meter long 3D printer. And that allowed them to save up to 80% on construction costs, up to 60% on labor costs, and up to 60% on construction waste costs. Fuck, this is awesome. So if you pair all these technologies together, there's a very real opportunity here to disrupt the entire mess we're in and basically provide housing to everyone at near zero cost. So I don't know, like, just off the top of my head, like, maybe you could crowdfund a huge, like, fairly flat area of land, a plot of land, maybe 2 or 3 hours out of a major city, with transport access and water access. And then exploit the government's stupid rules to actually, like, borrow a shit ton of money to build 3D printed structures and literally build a brand new city that's basically free to live in. Now, these structures would be good. Like, when you think 3D printed house, you think this weird, shitty plastic thing. Go and have a look at these things, this thing they built in Dubai. It looks like a really freaking awesome office building. Perhaps what you could also do is actually create a cryptocurrency for this new city where it enables anyone to invest. So if you actually want to buy a property there, you have to actually invest into this coin, which then enables you to build more structures. And so I guess the whole point of this exercise would be to basically try and crash the market to cause the property bubble to burst. Because what you're doing is you're basically trying to reduce the rental demand on a mass level, which reduces property investment. Because I'm not talking about just 3D printing, you know, a couple of structures. You know, it's not going to be like the tech commune or hippie commune idea I had a while ago. This would literally be 3D printing an entire city within 2 years. Because if you can 3D print an entire city that can house a million people within the space of a few years, with all the comforts, all the luxuries, all the infrastructure you'd expect from a normal city, and it's just 2 or 3 hours outside a major city. And because your construction costs can be at least 10 times cheaper, therefore your rental prices can be at least 10 times cheaper, and you disrupt everything. I mean, why pay 10 times the rent when you can pay 10 times less? And if you pair it to this like cryptocurrency idea, basically like the DAO, the blockchain, can own all the property. No one owns it, everyone rents it at very low cost. Because suppose your endgame goal is basically to build 500,000 to 1,000,000 3D printed structures to house 1,000,000 people. What you can do is every piece of income from all those people gets pulled onto the blockchain to build more 3D printed structures. And imagine what would happen to the market if suddenly tomorrow there was 1,000,000 new properties for rent at a tenth the cost that was only a 2-hour self-driving trip away from a major city. Not only would this city become a cool place to live full of counterculture types, young people, artists, creatives, entrepreneurs, but it would actually help burst the property bubble, thus turning shelter into a commodity. Snappy thoughts at Future.